went to LA for my spring break, and this may have been one of the craziest adventures that I've ever been on. My Chinese friend comes to visit me, his first time in America. I go to Vegas, I hitchhike from Barstow, California to LA. I went to Venice Beach, ended up playing 5-on-5 against LAPD, and then to cap it off, I saw Kobe play. What made LA so cool was my friend Victor. He was coming to America for the first time and he wanted to share this experience with me. Victor was my friend that I met when I was in China, and he took me under his wing. So all the various places that I went, the Great Wall, Mount Huashan, all of that, it was done because Victor took me to those places. Man, but getting to LA was an experience in itself, man. I had to catch 3 flights. I went from BWI to Charlotte, Charlotte to Chicago, Chicago to LA. And then I got out there like noon, and Victor's plane didn't land until 9. So I was literally just sitting around for 9 hours. Then after that, we had to catch a flyaway bus because my buddy Darius, who I played basketball with at one of my community college, we were staying with him. Being in LA and driving on the bridges that you see in movies, that's when it really hit me. And then we saw In-N-Out, and I knew I had to try it because, you know, that's only a West Coast thing. So the next day, that's when everything started to happen. And Victor, he wanted to go out like at 8 a.m. I was like, bro, don't nothing open up this early. But we went out, we caught the Metro down to Hollywood Boulevard, saw all the stars. And then we later went up Runyon Canyon. And we climbed a mountain in China, so it was only right we climbed a little mountain in LA. After we left Runyon Canyon, I took Victor to Chinatown.
What did you think of Chinatown?
I think it's nothing about China. It's nothing like China, man.
We were exhausted, so we went back to Darius' place, and then we got ready to go to Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles.
First things first, after Mac, the Chronic is back. This is Endo, produced by Timbo.
Okay, this was the day that me and Victor set out to go to Vegas, but, you know, before that, we had to hang out because we didn't leave until, like, 5 o'clock. So it was funny. Me, Darius, and Eric, we actually saw Victor smoking backwood, which we've never seen, and Victor did it. And surprisingly enough, he actually liked it. I caught my first lift. We went to Sunset Boulevard to get something to eat. And then we went to Union Station to get ready to board our boat bus to go to Las Vegas.
Wait,
do you want some cup of tea? Oh, man, it's bloody cold. It's bloody cold outside.
Welcome back to Union. Catch the bus. Off to Vegas.
Oh, okay. That's the only thing.
Catching the boat. Las Vegas was cool, I guess. I mean, it was nice to be there and see the stuff that I've seen in movies and things, but it wasn't what I thought it was going to be. I thought I was going to see Sam Rothstein and prostitutes running everywhere, a bunch of gambling, and it just didn't happen. But I can't see how people get lost in the lights. But nonetheless, it was nice to be there. So the next day, you know, I took Victor to Checkers. He loved it.
Say it again.
This is the best French that I ever ate.
The French fry?
Yeah, the French.
The French?
I want to buy a lot of it and take it back to China.
And then we had some time on our hands until our boat bus came back. So we went to Old Vegas and went through there. And that was more interesting than present day Vegas.
Welcome to Old Vegas.
Oh!
Ah! Yeah, man, so once we left Vegas, we went to Barstow. You know, for a rest stop to get something to eat. And so me and Victor get off, and he didn't want to eat Carl Jr., so we thought of getting Polo Loco. So we go there, and I'm telling Victor, yo, the bus gonna get ready to leave. And he was like, nah, it's not gonna leave us, bro. I'm like, bro, they gonna leave us. So it's like 9:10, and then when we walk out of Polo Loco, the bus was in full stride, and I'm just standing there. And then I just start letting off all these F-bombs, because I'm pissed, because our stuff is on the bus. And Victor, he's all calm and collective. And then he starts trying to hitchhike us a ride. I'm like, bro, don't nobody do that no more. And then some guy overheard me cursing and things, and he was like, yo, I'll take you to the bus station, and you can, you know, catch another bus. And I'm like, all right, cool. So he takes us there, and there are no buses. So again, I let off one of the loudest F-bombs ever. And this guy comes out of nowhere and was like, what's wrong? And I sat and told him, and then he told me who he was. And
so we get stuck in Boston, and then Cowboy singing in Vegas.
Yeah, just me, the magnificent Michael Jackson.
Go ahead, give him one time. Give it to him one time.
Hey, pretty baby, with your high heels on.
Yeah.
You give me fever like I never, ever knew.
Yeah.
The way you make me feel, you make me feel, really turn me on.
Yeah.
You turn me on. You knock me off of my feet now, baby.
Yeah. That's enough. Don't get too much.
Hey,
don't get
I gotta save my goddamn book, cause I done fucked up. I've been out here in the desert till all the dust have went in my throat.
Nah, don't get too much.
And for $40 a piece, Cowboy took us to LA.
So the next day, we spent all morning trying to locate our stuff, because again, our stuff was left on the bus. And I wasn't so worried about my stuff, because all I had was electronics. But Victor had his passport, so we had to find that. So we went through so much. We went back to the Union Station to find it. They didn't have it. Then we talked to one of the bus operators. They told us it was like 30 minutes on the other side of town. We ended up walking to the Greyhound station to meet one of the people who we thought had it. So we had to go through so many channels. And then one guy was like, if it's somebody's in the ball office, I'll go check. So he comes and he takes us with us. But then he keeps walking into a part that we couldn't go into. And then we were like separated by like 50 yards. And then I just remember him walking out of the office with both bags in his hand. It was like a scene from a movie. So after we locate our stuff, Darius' roommate Trey, you know, he took us out to Venice Beach. The car ride was super funny.
I'm
so excited. I'm gonna play in this town. I'm gonna play in this land.
Dropping 20 and 10.
Well, it's planet. You guys sounds like. Oh man, you try to stop me, you can't. You ain't nothing. You try to stop me, you can't.
I looked around like.
It could be
a
lot of different things. It doesn't smell like fat burger, though.
Turn left.
I heard you, nigga.
This is my jam. You gotta say Venice Beach in Chinese.
Venice what? Beach in Chinese. Venice, Hai Tan.
There you go. That's where we are.
Then I met up with my homeboy, Kareem. He moved out to L.A. to be an actor, and we used to play basketball together at Stevenson. So we met up at Venice Beach, and we had fun. The most amazing thing happened when we were out there was we were playing 3-on-3, waiting to get onto the main court, you know, just waiting until our turn came. And then LAPD come on there and say, can we get next? And we're like, sure. Now, you read about things about police interacting with, you know, inner city people or urban people, black people, but you never think that you'll experience it. I mean, you see it on social media, but, you know, just to do it, it was so cool. And it was cool because, you know, there's not a lot of positive things with police and blacks, and then we get to be a part of something positive. And surprisingly enough, they actually could play. I mean, we still won, but you know, we had like this big crowd gathering and people actually didn't cheer once we won. They were like, then, you know, it was cool in itself.
When I started balling, I was young. You won't think about me when I'm gone.
top it off, after all the craziness that has happened this whole entire trip, me and Vic, they go see Kobe. And ironically enough, it was against the Wizards.
Vic, we at the Staples Center.
I don't know how to say it. Not now, man. Not now.
And that was cool, just to see, you know, one of the greats play in his last year.
Fade away. Nice pass.
Yeah.
Whoa.
What's up?
This is the last time we're going to see each other for another couple months.
Yeah.
It was a pleasure, bro. It was a hell of an experience. Hitchhiking from Vegas,
uh-huh.
Kobe playing LAPD at Venice Beach. It was a blast, bro. Thanks for coming up.
Yeah, I'm pleasure to play with you guys. I'm true.
No, you did good, but we always bros. Bros forever.
Yeah. But Kevin, you're going to meet, you know, at Shanghai or Shenzhen. Or
yeah, we're definitely going to meet again. Luckily, hopefully I study in China this summer, okay?
You will,
bro. Alright,
bro. Yeah.
Darius, man, thank you for opening up your doors, man.
No problem.
The greatest hospitality in my eventful Los Angeles.
I'm happy he's still alive. Career. I'm so happy he's still alive.
So thanks, bro.
You're a good man. Keep traveling.
I'm gonna try to.
Take my friend in the back.
So I just want to say thank you, Cowboy.
You're welcome, man. Hey, I'm your brother to the end. I'm like Chuck, I ain't gonna change my stripe. I'm always here for you to the day I die. So you call me, I'm coming. You just guide me the way I need to go.
Yes, sir.
And I'm gonna do it in the name of Jesus.
And much success to you. Oh, man. You win that. And I know you're gonna win that.
It's ours. We gonna take it. Give me that.
Thank you, brother.
All right. Thank you, too.
Yes, sir.
You too.